We are delighted to be joined by Dr. Kiran Bedi, the Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, to speak about how they tackled COVID-19. Welcome to India Head, Dr. Bedi. It's such a pleasure to be speaking with you.
Thank you, Sudha. Thank you.
So, Dr. Bedi, you know, in retrospect, when we all look back, you know, at these 9 dreaded months, as it were, how do you look back, Dr. Bedi, when the world was struck by this dreaded pandemic?
I think initially we were all groping and hoping that this will not last much. None of us knew how long it's going to last. If you see from the way we started with one day Tali Bajao, then one day lockdown to see whether we can all really all come close together and have a lockdown, whether we can have a Janta curfew, how even our Honorable Prime Minister started with one day at a time, and then few days, and then it went into weeks. I think the whole world was experimenting with it. It was not knowing where it was going. It didn't even know whether it was a pandemic or an epidemic, or is it a virus? So it was a mystery disease for all of us. It was equally a mystery for us in Pondicherry, and all hoping that it will go away very soon.
Yeah. So, Dr. Bedi, you know, although we all had this, you know, we were all facing the coronavirus, but somehow I think every experience, like much in life, we know when we are struck by any kind of a tragedy, we all come to terms in our own little ways. Now, if I were to ask you, Dr. Bedi, considering you were very involved in how to put a lid on the coronavirus pandemic, what were the 3 major challenges faced by Puducherry, Doctor?
The challenges was bringing all agencies together. The challenge wasn't a whole new culture. Number one, if it was in public administration, a culture of working together. Culture of now subsuming yourself to make it a departmental and an administrative success rather than you individually or an individual department success. Number one was, how do you subsume yourself to work for collective success? And second major thing was the people.
Right.
They understand or not. I think this was both administrative and social culture. Culturally, to make people understand, to believe you, to trust you, to understand you, and to abide by the law. And the second, of course, as I told you, administratively, come together.
Dr. Bedi, I also spoke to you during Nivar, you know, how you were coping with the arrangements of keeping the people of Puducherry safe and secure. And even at that time, you had reiterated that unless all the agencies come together, nothing like this is going to be possible. So far as COVID is concerned, just elaborate a little, Dr. Bedi, as to how did all the agencies, or rather, how the stakeholders came together to put a lid on this virus, Dr. Bedi?
I think the crisis forced us to come together, because it's a silo culture in our administration still. Doctors want to work within doctors. Each dispensary wants to work by itself. Every hospital wants to work. Private hospitals don't want to be cooperating. Internships, whether it's private, if it's students, they must not come with government. Government need, even within governments. So I think it was quite, then medical and enforcement with the police. And then the municipal authorities, because sanitation was so critical. So everybody is in silos. We all work together. Normal times is we don't work together. Working together is not our culture of working. So that to me, what was your question?
No, I was saying that, you know, that all the stakeholders came together. So I just wanted you to elaborate a little, because we saw how many blogs you wrote, Dr. Bedi, and I would read them regularly. And also we saw what, you know, the chief minister was doing at his end. And, you know, there were lots and lots written about Puducherry. And I will come to that, you know, how it was one of the few places where coronavirus was actually, you know, you almost took charge of it and saw to it that, okay, you do this and you do this, and then there is going to be synergy. So I just wanted you to elaborate a little on that, Dr. Kiran Bedi.
Sudha, because everybody found the wolf at the door. When everybody found that the virus is now going to directly hit you, if as a doctor, as medical profession, you don't deliver, you're going to get affected. Policemen, if you don't work together, you're going to get affected. Municipalities, if you don't politicians, political leaders, I think we all saw the wolf right at the doorstep. It's staring at us. So COVID right. was staring at us those yeah. months. And now everybody realized that there's no option but to work together. But the question is, who brings you together? Who will bring you together? And right. in administration like Puducherry, yes. there are three people who bring you together. One is the leader of the cabinet, which is the chief minister. Then the bureaucracy, which is the chief secretary. And as an administration, the lieutenant governor. And the Disaster Management Act right. had fixed responsibility only on the CS and this. I was part of the government. I was not mentioned as lieutenant governor. It said lieutenant governor is a part of administration. There was no clear defined role, but right. as a role of government. Now, as a government, I can ask for a report. I can ask a report. And instead, or say, well, this is their role. But the question right. here is, was not this. We then decided that we all shall win together. So we started to do an afternoon review right. as lieutenant governor. So while the CM did his own reviews, undoubtedly, while the chief secretary did his own reviews, I brought everybody together on a daily basis. Daily basis. Right. I found while the HCM did it on occasional basis, how often he may say,
right.
the chief secretary also did it on a regular basis, but I brought them on daily basis.
Right.
Because I felt that this is now a daily homework. That is the difference we did.
Right.
So I brought them daily at a fixed time.
Yes, Dr. Bate.
Everybody does a Google talk or a Google coming together by Zoom or by audio call, audio visually. We did it even on audio. When the right. audio was right. not so sharp, we did it audio. Right. So we were doing it on the BSNL phone where we could bring 20 together, 11 together. So we brought everybody together. And now we start to ask the right questions. And minuting together, sharing the minutes together, assigning roles together, ironing out the problems which were yeah. there, and then resolving. I think what we did was every day together. And at my level, before you right. came together, the control room came together. The doctors came together. The enforcement came together. The chief right. secretary brought everybody together.
Yes.
When they came to meet together, yes, they were all together.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Dr. Bedi, one day this will all form part of a book, I'm sure, you know, and our great grandkids will sit and read about it, because this is really unbelievable. And that's why in India Ahead, we are, saluting the COVID warriors who've done such stellar work. You know, Dr. Bedi, it takes me back. I remember when Puducherry found the first person who may have been impacted by it in Mahi, and one saw that what the other states had done, Puducherry had actually taken a lead on it because it had blocked all the roads. If you may recall, Kadalur Road, Thindiavanam, it had, all these roads, the East Coast Road, it was all blocked. So I'm saying that in many ways, Puducherry, Dr. Bedi, is an example, because what they did right in the beginning, the rest of the states were following. Not that I'm sitting on, apportioning blame, but don't you think that there was some remarkable work done by Puducherry?
Sudha, before I come to this next question, very good question. I mustn't forget the role which Government of India played for us. Because when we found the wolf at the doorstep, I tweeted right. saying we need the Government of India on our side. And we need the ICMR, Indian yeah. Council of Medical Research. And we want the intervention of the Prime Minister and the Home Minister. And the next day, interventions came, support came. ICMR with its expertise came and the Ministry of Health came, the whole ministry came, and it turned the corner from third week of August. So it now became
all
more
right.
strict.
Yeah. Yes.
I want to say that this is how when we also, like, not only did I bring them together in the afternoon, we also cried for help. We were not afraid of asking for help. So I tweeted it. Because how else right. do I write? Writing, there's no time to write. So I tweeted it, saying that Puducherry in need of help. And the best part is that the tweet was responded by all Home Ministry, Prime Minister's Office, Ministry of Health, and ICMR, and the JIPMed. Now the team, and thereafter right. we have now remained under control. I thought that was the very important point where we cried for help, asked for help,
yeah,
and we got the help.
Yeah, that's. Yeah. Yes, Dr. Bedi. Yeah, that's very important, because you say that when you find the wolf at the door, there is no shame, but you know, cry out for help, and then the synergy happens, and in a way things become streamlined, and you know, you all walk towards the same direction and perhaps find a solution. Dr. Bedi, I had asked you about, you know, when you found the first case in Mahe, and how you know Puducherry administration had taken all measures to kind of block all the roads. You know, weigh in on that, Dr. Bedi. You know, that was really something which was out of the box, isn't it?
It was collective thinking, Sudha, because when I said we were all coming together every afternoon, everybody found their own solutions, and the regional administrators who were on the job, they were heard, and solutions came from them. That's what administration is about, is to listen to the others and find the best solutions. And that's how borders were crossed. Why? Because yes. Kerala was getting very active. Kerala was becoming very, very active because of the very heavy traffic they get from overseas. And then we also had the Tamil Nadu side, which was also getting the Karikal, Nagapattinam side from Karikal. All of them were very, very virus. They were actually multiplying while we were still safe. And we were wondering, why were we as an island safer comparatively, till it hit us again. So we were sealing the borders and then checking and then e-passes. So these all policies which came because of collective thinking of coming together. And they came through all these forums, as I mentioned to you, whether it was at the level of HCM, the CS, or mine.
Right. Dr. Bedi, another challenge I think with Puducherry faced, you know, you said that, you know, how do we keep this island safe? It's a touristy place. You know, people go there because of its beautiful beaches. There is an ashram. Do you think that it became doubly a challenge for you because you had to be extra careful? No, Dr. Bedi?
So that tourism fell because people stopped coming for us. But what we would do with the, but what was happening was the seepage, because people from Tamil Nadu were coming in Mahe, Kerala. People went to work. After all, lockdown was not for, you had to go to work. So it was a cross infection serving, whether it was from Tamil Nadu and Pondicherry or whether it was Andhra Pradesh. We forget that Yanam is linked with Kakinada. So we had Kakinada border, we had the Kerala model border, and then we had the Puducherry model, Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu, Kakinada, and then also Kerala, which was on the Kunur, all that side. So we had three options, and people were obviously going across to work and bringing into across, in fact. But people were also not understanding that the safety is the masking. But they took a long time to understand. That's why a lot of enforcement. Policemen actually now became COVID beat officer. From criminal crime to COVID, we became crime to COVID. So they would know where is the case today, and they would go visiting homes. They would work with the ANMs and work with the Anganwadis, and they become joint teams, whether it was health and police. For the first time, law enforcement assumed a new role of patient prevention, patient identification, and patient care.
Right. You know, Dr. Bedi, one of the images, and I think it will recur forever, is the migrants walking home, you know, with no really future. They didn't know where they were going. They were just walking, like they say, ki chalte ja rahe hain, manzil ka kuch pata pata nahi hai. Now, you know, so far as migrants are concerned in Puducherry, you know, I followed Puducherry right from the beginning as to how this island is managing. Apparently, when it came to migrants, and there were some companies which were wanting to send back migrants, the administration and the government, of course, put its foot down and said, no, you will deal with them here. Elaborate on that, Dr. Bedi. How did you deal with the migrants?
So I think we were fortunate. We didn't have the kind of number and the scale which Maharashtra had or Delhi had, Pondicherry being a composite place. So I think we were lucky. But even if we were small and we had a smaller number, we dealt with each life with very great care. So we did go back. I think real messaging, the migrant labor was avoidable. But at that time, as I said, everybody was still understanding the problem and they didn't understand. So messaging had to be better. So I think we quickly learned the lessons from others' mistakes. And others' mistakes was the kind of messaging they give to others. They need to win their trust. So we did. We connected with them. We looked after them. We sheltered them. Food and clothing, water, healthcare, everything, and also help them migrate. Means if you want to take a train, but we were also constantly guided by the Government of India's standard operating procedures. By the time we also learned lessons, I think we quickly learned lessons from others' mistakes.
you know, people who were actually following, we at India Ahead, you know, we have our prime focus on the South Indian states and of course the Union Territory of Puducherry. The thing is that, you know, the reporters who went there, they found that the messaging was superb. The communicating with people was really stellar. They saw that autos were apparently fitted with mics. You know, they said, where do you see this? This is, you know, long time ago, Dr. Bedi, you know, when a new film would release, you would see in villages, you know, these itinerant, you know, rickshaws going and saying, you know, falan film release hui hai. They said in Puducherry, we saw this, autos fitted with mics. They said on primetime television, on, you know, radio, they said they were bombarding with messages and not just one language, but multiple languages. So the reporter who went there, they said, you know, it's too much. I said, communication, I think, and you should correct me on that. Communication is never too much. It's about, you know, whether the communication is actually ingested by the people. So communication was really top of the list for Puducherry. Isn't that, Dr. Bedi?
I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful to you that you observed us. I didn't. The kind of observation you're making, I didn't observe myself. All we did was that there was a very, very intensive messaging. Because the more you educate, the more the prevention. So prevention doesn't happen out of ignorance. Therefore, we kept informing people through all. That's why I said we became the beat officer, the medical officer, they all had these megaphones. And why they had the megaphone? Because if I speak with a megaphone, I reach 1,000. But if I just speak like maybe I reach 100.
Right.
So our object was to use the same energy, same time, with the thanks to the communication tool that we reach more. So it was a reaffirmation. And then it was not only that. We used to wade through the Sunday markets. The IGPs, then police officers and beat officers would take the mics along and wade through the fish markets saying separate, social distance, sanitation, masking, messaging. So messaging actually was very critical because we wanted people to be saving themselves because this is the first time they were being told to do at mass scale, at 100% scale. But the good point is that Indians still listen. We do still listen. I've come across certain European countries are saying, why should you tell us? We'll decide what we want to do. It was not this. It was not a single case in India, in my place here. We say, who are you? Why are you telling me? Not one. On the contrary, they say, thank you. You are taking care of us, but you're overdoing. They might be saying, okay, you are. I know, but I can have a dupatta here, wire mask. So I think we were successful, but yes, you're right. Every day we had programs of LED on the beach, megaphones, television, weekly messages, yes. Radio phones, FMs, secretaries coming up on the television. We did not leave, and our own social media, we did not leave a single avenue of communication unfulfilled or
unutilized. Yes, and Dr. Bedi, let me add also, you were writing regularly for people, you know, to speaking about, there was poetry, there was philosophy, there were life lessons in what you were writing, and there were just reports, considering the background that you have, there were also official reports. But this was a beautiful mix, Dr. Bedi, because I have read most of the blogs that you wrote. I want to ask you, you started this conversation, Dr. Bedi, look at it, look at the trajectory of where it's gone. You began by saying, you know, the thing is that we can never not work together. And now, into the show, and you're saying we all learned how to work together. So tell me something, Dr. Bedi, considering you have experience and you have worked with some of the human beings who perhaps did not have the hope of reforming, but you always had the hope. Do you think COVID taught India the lesson that if we all stand together and fight, then we can?
It has taught us the lesson that good administration is a preparation for any crisis. I think that's the biggest lesson. And good administration cannot happen in isolation. All departments have a reason to work together. So the key coordinators must play the coordinating role. And I mentioned the three positions. They are playing the, and so did the MHA. They played the coordinating role through auto-visuals and our political leadership led by the Prime Minister himself. So I'm not flattering anybody here. I'm just placing on record that this leadership compelled everybody to coordinate. While we believed in coordination, we were also being told to coordinate and do. I think this helped us make things a little easier. But the prep message is very clear. You want to prevent any crisis? work together in peace and normal times. You'll be ready for any crisis. And we immediately benefited by this coordinated functioning through the cyclone, because cyclone came during the, when it was on the ebb,
right.
COVID was under control, cyclone came. And our whole control room system of working together was like from COVID to control room, COVID to cyclone.
Yes. Yes, Dr. Bedi, even as, you know, the nation and the world rather is going towards a vaccine, you know, none of us can put a date to when it will happen, but there is hope on the anvil. What is your message for people? Because, you know, a lot of people now are already complacent, but coming from you, I think it will have a lot of weight. So what would you tell people that before the vaccine comes, what are they supposed to do, which is due diligence, Dr. Bedi?
I think the COVID behavior, the behavior which is being taught, is the social distance, the sanitation and the masking. We must continue. We'll have to continue for a long time. We must not infect each other. We must respect each other. I must respect you. You must respect me. Maintain a distance. Maintain the mask so that I don't infect you, you don't infect me, so that we can continue to work together. And also that we keep our sanitation, the hand sanitation and otherwise, etc. But we will remain vulnerable. The only option is keep working together, listening to each other, work on each other's potential. Our resources are not inadequate. Our resources are inadequate only when they don't work together. I've noticed when we all pulled in together, we had fair enough to respond, and yet we were strengthened. So I think the message is pooling together, thinking together, listening to each other together, work on each other's potential and strengths, and then bind together, bond together, rehearse together, and work together,
yes,
and message together, and people will then trust you and listen to you and then abide by.
Yes. Dr. Kiran Bedi, it was such a pleasure speaking to you. Thank you so much for joining us on this e-conclave on COVID-19. Thank you indeed.
Thank you, Sudha.